G'day Australia, I'm Korum E in the fabulous Pipistrel Alpha Electro. We've had a few requests online from people on various channels for an in-cabin noise test or check or an example of what the noise is like in an electric plane during regular takeoff configurations. So what I thought I'd do is go out and do a circuit at Jandakot Airport and show you just how much noise is in the cabin through the regular takeoff and landing procedure. The way I'm going to do it is I've got a lapel mic on, which will simulate what the sound is like in this area where your head and your ears are in an electric aircraft. Rather than try and pick it up from the mic on the phone, wouldn't have worked very well at all because it's in a bit of an odd spot. So this should simulate pretty well what the sound is like in the plane. And we'll run through the whole process, and I've got another camera angle that we'll cut to every now and then as well, and that'll show you the whole configuration of how we set up the aircraft for takeoff, how we set it up for landing, and complete a full circuit at Jandakot Airport in Western Australia, which is a Class D controlled aerodrome, so there'll be a bit of activity on the radio as well. I've already done my external checks on the aircraft. We've done half of the internal checks as well, so we're pretty much ready to go. So I've got my taxi clearance, and now I'm just, I've got my circuit clearance. Now we've just got to get a taxi clearance and get moving. Jandakot Ground Electro 2055, that's with information, Foxtrot, request taxi for circuits. Taxi and hold short, runway 06 left, Electro 2055. All right, here we go. Prop live. Prop is now live. Systems are engaged, no warnings. So we can spool up the prop and get a bit of power. All right, we're in motion. Just make sure the brakes are working correctly. Very good. Okay, and we're off. We're up in the northern apron at Jandakot Airport, which is a little bit of distance from the runway. Now, interestingly, the audio today, you've only got the audio from the mic. I haven't patched through the radio at all, so you'll only hear my side of the radio, of course. But during taxi, it's obviously quite quiet. We're using very little energy and very little prop disturbance with the air off the front of the aircraft. And then about the only thing you can hear is the bearing brakes. These brakes have a floating disc which rattles a little bit in the calipers, in the wheel when the brakes aren't applied and they're spinning on the ground. But we don't hear any of that in the air, of course, and we don't hear it when the brakes themselves are applied. It quietens them up. But we don't really use the brakes much in the Electro because we don't have an idle. We're not really going faster than we want to when taxiing. So the power back to zero and the aircraft slows down. And similarly, when landing, it's such a light aircraft, there's good drag when the fuel station collapses. It's a big full drag pack. So you can do most of slowing down on the runway just with air resistance and adding a bit of drag without having to physically apply the brakes. So your brakes last forever. Right, we're just at the holding point, waiting here. There's a little bit of traffic ahead of us. And there's a little bit of traffic in the pattern, which is why we're held up here, just waiting for a gap, which is fine, because unlike every other aircraft, our prop is stationary at the holding point. So we're not using any energy at the moment. There's no noise, heat, exhaust, all of the horrible things you normally get at a holding point. We're just chilling. And the poor guys in front of us are burning fuel, burning energy, and getting engine heat and all sorts of other things, which I know is a problem for some aircraft at the holding points, but we don't have those problems. We also went straight past the run-up bay because we have no run-ups to do. There's really only one check that's required, and we can do that while taxiing. And we got that out of the way on the way here. So more time saved, more time flying. All right, we've got our lineup clearance. The aircraft is in takeoff configuration, one stage of flap, and we'll line up here and then get our takeoff clearance in a moment. And here we go. Traffic inside cleared for immediate takeoff, Electro 2055. All right, we've been cleared for immediate takeoff, so we'll apply full power. In this case, it's 56 kilowatts. If you're under, we're looking for about 45 knots for a rollout. There we go. And we are now airborne. We're going to climb now. Looking for about 70 knots on the climb. And then we're going to about 200 or 300 feet, which is right about now. Take the climb away and reduce the power to about 32 kilowatts of climb weight. Okay. And then still looking for 70 knots on the climb, which we're reaching now. And stop those vents there a little bit. That's a very busy day in the traffic pack today. Very exciting, keeping me on my toes. So well, we know soon how we look. Yep. That aircraft is well ahead of us. Very good. We're at 600 feet now, and so we're just going to take a turn and make our traffic pattern. Still cruising along around 70 knots here. That's our best climb speed. And we're going to climb up to 1,000 feet for those who aren't familiar with the circuit configuration here at Jandakot. And there we go. And then we're going to level out at 1,000 feet. So we're now level at 1,000. We bring the power back under 20 and maintain straight and level flight. And I've got our traffic in sight. We might do one go around and then we'll do a full stop after that. So power, temperature looks good. Ready to turn and make a call for the tower. Check the power with the 25, turn it down before touching the curve. Dropping it tight at 25. Okay, so we're on downwind now. I've got the traffic ahead of us in sight. They're on height as well. Profile here. We're parallel with the runway now, cruising on downwind, gaining a little bit of speed with that tailwind. And I'll start my downwind check, so I've told the tower what my intentions are. So I'm going to check brakes, undercarriage of course is fixed. We don't check mags and mixtures, but we do an equivalent, which is keeping an eye on our power system. Everything's looking good there, there's no warnings on any of our systems. We've got three core temperatures to observe there. Fuel, we check the equivalent thereof, which is our onboard battery energy, and hatches and harnesses, which are all secure. So the downwind checks are pretty similar to any typical aircraft. We're just checking battery instead of fuel, instead of mags, which is where we just have an extra look at our temps on the system. The temperatures, we're looking at our battery temperatures, the inverter temperature, and the motor temperature. Three separate indicators on the display here, and they're all well within the green. All right, so we're getting to the point where we're ready to configure for landing. Slow the aircraft down a little bit. So I'll bring the nose up, bring the power back to nothing. And then we're looking for one stage of flap up to 70 knots, under 70 knots. So I might just take that after the turn. And there we go, we're on speed. Turning down now, losing a bit of height. And take that first stage of flap, keep it under 70 knots, and that'll help us drop a bit of that height and set up for our landing configuration. Still got the traffic ahead of us in the pattern there, but plenty of space between us and them, so we've got some room to maneuver. We've kept a nice tight traffic pattern, which we normally do in the Electro, and there's no need for a really super long final in a maneuverable aircraft like this. Set everything up really nicely on a short final. Alright, so speed and height's good. We're looking for our turn shortly, so just adding a little bit of power there to slow our seat rate. Going to turn into final now, and we're going to slow down a little bit more, take that second stage of flap, and that'll bring us down, lower our speed a little bit to 55 knots. I'm looking for a late final. So let's get it under 60 knots. There we go. Under 60 and take that second stage of flap. And then now we're just going to float on in. A little bit of power to simulate an idle. We're looking for 60 knots, mid final, 55 knots, late final. We don't want to be down to about 50 knots when getting ready for the hold off. And the aircraft will just very nicely touch down. and no dramatic stall in this lovely aircraft. These fabulously long wings. And then we'll reset. Clear touch and go, Electro 2055. We'll reset for our second circuit. So everything's looking good, angle's good, height's good. Need to manage the height a little bit there. And we'll slow her up just a little bit. Get her down to about 55 now. That's nice. Just the tiniest touch of crosswind there. All right, now I'm about 50 knots, late final, power off completely. Set off that hold off, gently kiss the ground, reset the flap to one stage, apply full power, get airborne, get rid of that wheel wobble that is the wheel balance, and then same again. We're going to climb out to about 200 or 300 feet, then take that flap away completely and bring the power back. We've got height and speed, we know we're flying, we've got bird speed. Bring that flap back to zero, bring that power back to about 40. Ripping along at 80 knots now, so you can climb a little bit. And just climb about 70. That'll get us climbing nice and fine. Alright, we're now at 600 feet, so we'll take a turn. Keep that bad boy in balance. Put a rudder input control on the Alpha Electro to keep it in balance. And it really keeps your hands on your toes. It's a good thing, you don't get lazy in the rudder in this aircraft. It's a lot of control surface area and a light aircraft, so very slight input makes a difference. So we're always active on the rudders. We're still recording on all fronts, and we're now at 1,000 feet, so we'll level off, bring the power back. Well under 20 kilowatts, the strength level, and we don't accelerate too much. We're just going to float around about 80 knots here, 75, 80. No rush. And we're ready to turn for downwind. Take the power back a little bit more. So we're right down to 10 kilowatts now. That tailwind behind us is ripping along. We've only got 90 knots airspeed. And we're only at 11 kilowatts. It's good. That's a very, very efficient power setting. It could fly along for quite some time, that power setting. Still speeding up there, so we'll bring the power back even more. And get a little bit of height there, get a little wobbly on my height. Don't look at the altimeter. All right, let's keep a clean circuit. Tidy up that height a little bit. I've done my downwind checks on the mine, brakes, undercarriage, mags, mixtures, temperature preferences, and fuel, plenty, hatches and harnesses, all good. And we'll set up for our landing configuration now. We've got no traffic ahead of us anymore that have landed. So I'm going to do a little bit of a tighter circuit on this one and come in and wash off some speed now. So take the power back to idle, which in our case is a zero. And it's going to turn in, take some flap, slow down. What a lovely day. It's always so beautiful here. Perth has stunning weather. That's why it's such a busy flight training area. There's got over 280 flyable days a year on average. So, clear to land, Electro 2055. Plenty of opportunity to fly. So nice here. And sometimes we get some pretty hectic crosswind, but very rarely are we rained out. Alright, so a little bit of a tighter circuit this time, and so it's going to turn my speed a little lower. But we're looking good. We've got the helicopter up ahead to be aware of. Got our landing clearance. So now I'm going to turn final. Slow us down a little bit more, get us under 60 so I can take that second stage of flap. And all right. So this is a slightly higher profile, but we're just going to glide on in now. Power's at absolute zero. And we're going to stick around 60 knots still. Late final. And then put it down nicely. And takes it to the runway. It's really nice. Every approach is a glide approach in the Electro, right? So we're at 300 feet now, 57 knots, still great. We're going to add just a slight touch of power to bring us in on this slope. We don't want to have to ruin anything on there, so we'll just adjust this speed a little bit, looking great. We're under 60 knots. We'll come down to about 55 on Lake Final. So nose up a little touch, power back a little touch. That'll slow us down there. Let us float on in. There we go, 57, 56, 55. Cool. Power is still off. We're just going to glide on, 53, 51. All right, ready for the hold off. And kiss the ground. And that's it. We're now on the ground. Take this next exit here. Go first down to wave. And we're done. That's 2 seconds in the Alpha Electro. I hope the noise came through pretty well. Oh, noise, or lack thereof, compared to a lot of other aircraft. And I hope that gave you a bit of insight into the configuration for takeoff and landing of the Electro. Pretty simple stuff, especially once you've done a bit of practice with our amazing instructors in Korea and Australia. We've got about 10 or 11 instructors now training in the electric planes, 3 planes operating in total. And they're busy. They're busy little planes. And they're doing great things in flight schools, offering cheaper rates to pilots, a really nice flying experience. Cheaper rates to flight school, less noise, a nicer flying experience, a less intimidating learning experience. There just really are a lot of advantages to flying electric. Jandakot ground, Electro 2055 at Foxtrot, request cross runway 06 left. Cross runway 06 left, taxi to line up, Electro 2055, thank you. All right, so that's the last permission I need from the tower, and it's time to head on back. Put this little girl, we just, okay, some indication of energy there. We've stopped at 88%, I don't know if you saw on the other camera angle, and we're down to 68-69% on the batteries. So, 20%, 2 circuits, 20%, and that's about typical. We're budgeting around 10% per circuit. So, obviously, the climb is the most energy intensive part of any flight, and we use about 10% for climb to 1,000, 12% to 1,500. Then the rest of our straight level flight we budget about really efficiently. As you saw when we were on downwind, our straight level power setting is 10 or 11 kilowatts to maintain straight level on downwind, whereas our takeoff configuration is 44 kilowatts. So we're literally using 1/4 of the power to maintain straight level flight. Rather than the flying. So when you're in that straight level configuration, you can just have flying low and slow, enjoying the view, doing some surveying, or doing some training, doing some turns, just doing the straight and level lesson, any of that. The power configuration is very efficient, and you can really squeeze that out in 40 or 50 minutes in the air with 2 people comfortably. When you're flying on your own, I've flown over an hour before in the air. The flight switch in the air. So it's a very usable amount of power. A lot of people are critical of the 1 hour use time, but if you keep it together, stay efficient, you can do a lot of things in an hour. And something else to keep in mind, the FA-18 Super Hornet fighter jet has a flight time of 60 minutes to fly further than that of mid-range, extending fuel tanks mounted underneath. So there's a lot of aircraft that have mission times of under an hour, and for recreational or flight training operation, an hour is a fabulously usable amount of time. We go on 45 minute, 70 to 80 kilometer joy flights, just a recreational flight with me and a passenger and me by myself up and down the Perth Coast all the time, or in the Yarra Valley where we've got another electric aircraft embedded with the Lidl Flying School in Yarra Valley. Absolutely stunning. Surely going to do some air testing in the Melbourne area. And of course, you can fly at Cloud Dancer pilot training in Jandakot, Western Australia, where we have a aircraft operating now.